about everybody has a Job experience. We will be using in reference Job chapter 1, verses 1 through 12. But to be honest with you, the whole book of Job is important. As fate would have it, we have the distinct opportunity to glean from the written word. I have chosen to recognize Job and the many challenges that he had faced. So let me introduce you to Job. Job was married to a nameless woman, characterized by a saying that I will later share in my sermon. Job was a father. He had 7 sons and 3 daughters. Job had 7,000 sheep, 3,000 cattle, 500 yoke of oxen, and 500 donkeys, and a large number of servants. Job was rich, and God described him as a mighty man. He was favored by God, blameless, and upright, and full of integrity. God has an insatiable desire to have our dedicated focus on him. You see, Job loved God, and he lived so holy that he even sacrificed burnt offerings for his children, who held feasts on an ongoing basis, serving drinks and having their way. His wish was to purify them regularly. You know, we often feel that it is necessary to have the nice things. And if you're like me, the desire to have a nice home, a nice car, clothes, it's all natural. We like our stuff, right? And Job was no different. Well, in chapter 1, verse number 6, the angels came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan was with them. The Lord said to Satan, "Where have you come from?" And Satan would respond by saying, "I'm roaming around throughout the earth, going back and forth in it. You know, the devil is busy." Now, whose life is he messing up? The Lord says, "Have you considered Job?" In other words, let me interject. We know you have plenty of people to keep you busy, devil. But have you considered Job? The Lord offers his best, the blameless and upright, the man who fears God and shuns the devil. Satan's light bulb clicks on. He fears God and shuns the devil. Have you put a hedge of protection around this man? Have you considered his household and kept him protected with everything that he has? You covering him, Mom, Lord? Okay, well, I'm gonna show you. So then the Lord says, "Hey, yes, that's true, but he's still dedicated to the love that he has for me." Knowing the devil, he needed to prove a point. Oh, well, you know, I'm interjecting and saying, "Oh, really? Let me check this out." So knowing the devil, he gets out and he says, "Lord, if you let me touch him, I'll make him curse you to your face." The Lord said, "Okay, Satan, you have your way. You can do what you want to do. But what I want you to do is don't touch a hair on his body. Don't touch him. Have your way." Now, how many times can we count in our lives that go smoothly and then out of the blue, something happens? Tragedy seems to become us. We find ourselves dreading the day we were born. My God, we're suffering greatly. The pain from the loss hurts so deep, and you don't even have the strength to carry on. Your car was totaled. One of your family members dies. You didn't even get that promotion on that job you knew you had in your hand. You're evicted, and you're not from not paying rent. Your husband or your wife doesn't come home at night. It's happening so fast you can't even catch your breath. You see, Job lost everything. Just keep on reading in chapter 1. The donkeys are gone, the sheep are gone, the cattle are gone, and then all of a sudden his children were gone. Bereaved, Job went into total grief And see, back in those days, when you were in grief, you're supposed to have shaved your head and tear your robe. Just tear it. Because you're devastated. A month and a half ago, I lost my mother. She died of cancer. That struggle was rough on me, as well as my family. I don't see nobody around here with shaved heads and a torn robe. But back in them days, that was critical, because that showed the world that you were in grief. And I'm in grief right now. But you know what? Why did I lose my mom? Why did Job lose everything he had? See, God holds us in a special stead. So, anyways, let's get back to the story. So, Satan returns, and he's shocked. Because even though Job had been devastated, he lost his children, his family, Job still fell down to the ground and prayed and worshiped God.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what we have to do when we're struggling with situations. We have to fall down to the ground and give our total worship to God. So, Satan returns with the other angels again and visits God, and Job was still praying. So Satan said, okay, all right, I took all this stuff and he's still praising God. I want skin for skin. So the Lord thinks about it. I don't think he's still going to give up. I think God is really confident that Satan is not going to win this battle. So, skin for skin it is. So Satan returns, and he tears up Job's body by covering him with sores from the head to the toe. Yes. Now remember his wife, you know, the one I talked about that didn't have no name? Her only words to Job was, are you still maintaining your integrity with God? Why won't you curse him and die? And Job replies by saying simply, we will accept good from God and not trouble. Job's focus was dedicated. So how many of us got someone in our circle of friends that's always cheering us on the side, just give up on God? It's easier, you know. He ain't gonna help you out. You know, in the story, Job was met by some of his friends, and they were supposed to be sympathizing with him. So for 7 days, he sat by the side of Job, his friends, three of his friends sat by the side of Job, and just was quiet and silent, sitting in patience, wondering, this man is going through a lot. What can we do? And so they, too, were encouraging Job to give up. They had no other way. They were like, if anything like that ever happens to me, I would give up. But giving up wasn't a choice. So now I want you to take an opportunity to think about your Job experience. What is the things that go into your mind about Job and his life and what he suffered and compare it to things that you're suffering in your life right now? I need to hear somebody say out loud. You don't even have to. It might not even be related to you, and maybe something that's going on, just period. Speak out loud and say, give me an example. I lost my mom.
I lost my father.
You lost your daughter. You lost your father.
I lost my brother.
You lost your brother. And that's when you're faced with some times and trials in your life, heart attacks. You know, you just got described with cancer. All of those things are challenges that are brought before us, but we think that those things are brought before us for a suffering? A suffering? The Job experience was purposeful, okay? Our suffering happens for reasons that sometimes we don't even understand, unless or until God reveals that to us. So sometimes we've been going through our trials and tribulations in our life. You want to just give up, you want to throw in the towel, but the bottom line is, look at the end results. If you don't know the answer to why God has implied your life the way that he has, just wait a little bit. In John chapter 9, 1 through 7, can I get somebody to read that out loud for me? John chapter 9, 1 through 7.
John chapter 9, 1 through 7.
John chapter 9, verses 1 through 7. If you have it, please stand up and just read it out loud for the congregation to hear.
1 through 7?
Yep.
As he went along, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" "Neither this man nor his parents sinned," said Jesus. "But this happened so that the works of God might be displayed in him. As long as it is day, we must do the works of him who sent me. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." After saying this, he spit on the ground and made some mud with the saliva. He put it on the man's eyes. "Go," he told him, "wash in the pool of Siloam." This means sent. So the man went and washed and came home seeing. His neighbors and those who had formerly seen him begging asked, "Isn't this the same man who used to sit and beg?" Some claimed that he was. Others said, "No, he only looks like him." But he himself insisted, "I am that man."
And so God had favor. Isn't that wonderful? A wonderful favor. Trials may come because God needs us to know something about being a faithful servant. And as I reflect on the 2.5 year battle of my mom going through this cancer experience, it was rough. Running up and down that freeway and going and checking on her and making sure that she is well. It was rough. But then I remember this one particular time frame, which was the last 10 days that I spent by her bedside. And I remember the Lord spoke to me carefully. He said, "I have you here for a reason. Spend your precious moments."
That's right.
Every day is precious moments. And God is asking for us to take that time to be with our loved ones.
Yeah.
Because tomorrow is never promised to any of us.
That's right.
Okay? And so I remember those days when I went out for a walk. I just said, "I'm going to take me a prayer walk, and I'm going to walk around this community. And I'm going to call my girlfriend," because I called her on the phone. She's here in the audience. And I said, "Girl, I'm trying to find a store. I can't find a store, but I'm walking." And while I was walking, God was talking. And he said, "Hey, girl, I need you to go back. I need you to go back and sit by your mom's bedside. Spend every precious moment you have with her. Because I don't know the day that I will take her from you. However, this time is precious and it's important." And I'll never forget, me and my daughter and her family traveled right on back to Minneapolis on that Sunday, because I'd been there for 10 days, so I'm like, okay, well, mama ain't going nowhere now. My mama's good for proving a point. She ain't going nowhere, because don't nobody tell her when she's getting up out of here. Don't nobody tell her. She's gonna do her own thing. So we ride home. And I go to work on Monday, just as cheery like the rest of the people, and getting doing my work and doing my day, and then go to sleep Monday night, and Tuesday morning, they call. Mama's in her last time calling. She's breathing very deep. My mama did not want to go while I was sitting right there beside her. So that suffering, that experience of watching her go through those trials and tribulations, happened for a reason. Those 10 days was happening for a reason. Being faithful, serving God, and what God has asked for us to do. Number three, there is deep implications for our relationship with God. There's deep implications for our relationship with God. When we have our Job experience, we might not know what the answer is right now. But as God unfolds the pages before us, there's deep implications. It may not affect you. It may affect someone that you love.
Yeah.
It may not be for you. It might be someone who's watching what you're going through.
Right.
But God has a reason for why you're going through those challenges. God has a spiritual enrichment for each and every one of us to strengthen our relationship with God. I have a few chapters in the Bible that I want you to write down. I'm not going to read them, but I want you to write down. 2 Corinthians, verse 12, 7 through 10. 2 Corinthians, verse 12, 7 through 10. Hebrews, chapter 12, 4 and 12, Hebrews chapter 12, 4 through 12, James chapter 1, 2 through 4, and 1 Peter 4, 12 through 19. You see, trials and tribulations doesn't mean that God is punishing us. Suffering may have an expansive experience for our lives, but our faith in demonstrating the opportunity for God to get closer to us is what's important. Now, Job lost everything, right?
Yeah.
But if you keep on reading in the chapter of Job, you will find out that God not only blessed Job more than what he had before. He let Job live for a long time. How old was Job when he died? 200 years old. He's blessed. He was blessed. And so even when Job was stressing out with the sores on his body, he used to scrape his own body so he could just put the pain off of him because he was suffering so hard. So when you're going through your trials and tribulations in your life, just remember, scrape away that pain just for a little bit. And it'll ease up for you. And you will find yourself in a position where that Job experience will be a part of Job experiences. And you will overcome them, and your relationship with God will be ever more important.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.